This is Diablo 4. We're here on PlayStation 5 Pro. The game is now enhanced. Be sure to like the video. Subscribing is great as well. That's right, Diablo 4, the well-received, well-loved, and massively expansive and exciting dungeon-crawling experience with a focus on multiplayer action, has become a little larger than it ever was before. Wow, that is one crazy-looking panther thing. Do I have that? Yes, I do! Anyways, I've been waiting to check out Diablo 4 on the PS5 Pro Enhanced for a while here, but quite excited to finally dive in and showcase this game. I quite love this. I did, you know, a big review for it when it launched on the Series X. I covered it on Series S. I covered the expansion not too long ago that just dropped, the Vessel of Hatred, which was a lot of fun to dive into and enjoy. And then I went through it, I think, a second time for streaming to showcase the game for people in a streaming factor with my main character here. Because we had like a pre-launch build and everything. It was a big, it was a big deal. And then I got to play with my regular character after launch and showcase it. So that's all up on the channel if you want to watch me just mow through the Vessel of Hatred. But the game's really expansive, filled to the brim with detail. A return to a darker, grim-like era of Diablo action and dungeon crawling, which is really, really quite exciting if you're into that style, which I think the franchise really is all about, is that sort of dark immersion of, you know, chaos, things aren't going well, but you're some hero in this darkness trying to gather, you know, forces, armor, gear. It's mostly about the loot, let's be real here. So this game technically has two graphical modes to it. It doesn't, like, really, but it technically does have two graphical modes. So there's enriched, and then there's just regular. So by default, the regular option is playing, but you can go to options, and you can turn on the enriched visuals. So you're probably gonna notice the screen's just gonna, you know, takes a second to kind of push it. And what Enrich does is, I think you can immediately notice the, I would call it a bit of a choppiness kind of thing. Especially it seems a lot worse with the VRR kind of being enabled now. We'll talk about that in a sec. But so the Enrich visuals, what we're getting here is more of like your full 4K. Everything's got like an internal resolution scaling and then it bops up to 4K. But this is more of your like true full 4K. At 30 FPS. So what they've done here for this experience, specifically for the PlayStation 5 Pro Enhanced offering, is we now have the high quality ambient occlusion, like a higher or highest, they kind of call it, larger streaming caches for higher quality textures and geometry within the world, and the highest ray traced reflections possible. Basically, some of these settings were only, what was the phrasing they told me? Previously only reserved for the PC platform. So that's kind of exciting. I mean, the picture quality definitely looks a lot cleaner and a lot sharper in this mode. But the move to 30 FPS isn't, like, ideal to me, personally, in this kind of game. I'd like it to feel fast and vicious and intense. And the lower frame rate just doesn't really do that for me. But if you want to see how this game can really look, this is kind of your go-to option. Especially since the game can get really chaotic. If you're not familiar with, you know, Diablo, is like, you can have your screen just sort of filled to the brim with enemies and explosions. And, like, I'm not even playing with other people right now. Well, there's other people in the open world, right? Like, it's a seamless multiplayer kind of experience, right? But, like, you know, there's not even other people in this vicinity fighting things, and you can see all the stuff that's going on. So this is a cool mode just to kind of try and take a look at. I was hoping we'd have something to really reflect. That's the thing too, is like, unless you're going to one of like the cities or like a temple or something, or a dungeon that's specifically like shiny and reflective, you're not really, like, there's not a whole lot to reflect in this game, if that makes sense. Like, you're not really seeing that sort of thing in this world, but The setting is there, which is kind of exciting, I guess, if you're into that kind of thing. I was hoping this temple area would come up with, some sort of shiny reflective surfaces. Maybe the waterfall section would have been really beautiful in this for that. Oh, here we go. There he goes. Some ray traced reflections, I guess. Like, it's. That's what I'm saying, though, is like the game doesn't really have areas that are quite like that. I'm also surprised I have so little of this area. No, you know, that's because I did it with my character from the, what is that called? My main character, or not my main character, my review character I did that with, because we had a whole, like, review build, like I mentioned, and then now I'm playing with my regular character that I have, and then there's, you know, you're supposed to have seasonal characters and stuff. I can't keep up with all this. I can't keep up with all of this. But yeah, this is the enriched visual. So this is really showing you just how good it can look. And again, with the VRR, I don't know how that'll show up for you on your video. It might just be clean when you're watching this, but the VRR always kind of, well, in this case, it makes it feel a little off or something. Anyways, let's switch back to the regular kind of mode, because I'm sure the low frame rate's been bothering some people. So we're just gonna turn that off. It's gonna do this adjustment thing. Bam, and now we're back to the fluidity. Oh, yes, yes, yes. So we're getting a much higher resolution balance on this one now in terms of the internal resolution and then, you know, bopping up to 4K and output. It's still 60 FPS. It would have been cool to see them attempt to do, like, a high frame rate mode or something. And I don't know if this is just kind of a quick sort of, you know, getting the game going kind of thing, but that's kind of the status of it at the point in time. I think if there's, like, a really cool dungeon I should do, that maybe a dungeon that I haven't done would be really cool, but I think I've done practically everything. Like, I've been in everywhere in this game. Like, absolutely just everywhere. Like, I've gone around town. My character gets around. So this one also, like I mentioned, a higher resolution, higher quality models, higher quality textures, higher ambient occlusion, like a boost to it specifically they mentioned, and VRR support, so actually built-in VRR support. Wonder if the blood, one sec here, we're just kind of curious if maybe we get an enriched kind of thing on the blood. Yeah. Nah, not really. It looks better, the detail of the blood looks better, but I was kind of wondering, like, you know, if we get, like, reflective, reflective blood services. I'm sure there's some areas of this game where it would. Like, I'm trying to think of that, too. And there's some areas specifically within this game as well where the textures are actually bumped up even further than other areas. But they didn't really give further context on that. They're like, some areas really, really benefit from this more than others. And that in itself I found kind of rather fascinating. So, yeah. Significantly better here across the board, no matter what kind of graphical mode you try or play. The game is just going to look cleaner. I think in general it looks sharper too, so that is a nice bump up as well. Because I already thought the game looked quite fantastic, like visually. I thought it was a very beautiful game, personally. You know, like you got tons of different, like, character options with very advanced skill trees. Like, it's a very, very expansive and genuinely impressive offering. I've been thoroughly blown away by the gameplay and how addictive this game is. I'd probably play a lot more of it, too, if I wasn't, busy working all the time on videos and stuff. I wish I had more Diablo time. But yeah, it was a blast when this came out. I was just streaming a ton of it, and then covering the expansion was fun. And I'm sure I'll be, you know, every year, I would imagine, going forward. I'm assuming they're going to be doing more expansions, so we'll obviously be still covering Diablo. And should any other updates or anything come up, of course I'll jump right on that hype train and do that. So basically, big bump up in terms of fidelity for the performance mode and the enriched mode. And then you get a host of other visual upgrades to make them look a lot better. There's, like, not enough enemies to kill to feed the blood wheel here, which is becoming a problem. The wheel of blood needs to eat. Did I also mention HDR support? We've got HDR on this. which is expected. This game is, you know, multiplayer focused, so it's a seamless multiplayer world. There's always going to be tons of, I guess you would say, people to engage with, enemies to engage with, and you'll like just randomly come across people. There's like big world events and strongholds and things to do. It's kind of hard to siphon the blood for this if the enemies don't get near the blood wheel to feed it. As to say. That's disappointing. I think we missed out on bonuses there because, well, simply put, we didn't feed the blood wheel fast enough. It's mostly because I personally don't think they gave us enough enemies to feed the blood wheel. The giant pig thing. Yeah, I think I'm missing out on some events right now because I don't have this. This is like my like launch kind of character, so I don't have like the seasonal stuff going on. You know, Christmas in these majestic landscapes. That's what it's all about. It's a festive season. But yeah, this game does look. I wonder if this blood. I mean, see, I keep trying to find like weird, eerie surfaces to show off these visual improvements. I don't know, like, I think this is... Oh, okay, there you go, you can see the mountain, right? You can see the mountain kind of reflected in the blood, at least. Kind of hope so. It's like, it's kind of shallow, too, so you can see, like, in the rivers of blood, you can see... yeah, the rocks, like, it's shallow, too. Yeah, no, it actually does impact the surface, doesn't it? It did actually reflect there. Huh, neat. Subtle, but, you know... visible and stuff like that. Kind of cool, kind of interesting. I guess if you somehow never played Diablo 4, you're missing out on the best kind of dungeon crawling game out there right now. Yeah, I don't think there's really anything quite like Diablo. It'd actually be really cool to take a look at Diablo 2 Resurrected, because that was remade not too long ago, if you don't remember that one. That's like the classic, well-loved Diablo experiences, Diablo 2. And they like remade it a number of years ago, and you could like switch between the old and the new version, which was so cool. Yeah, this is a lot of fun. It's nice to actually have an excuse to sit here and go back and play some of this, because... yeah, I really do love this game. It's just an absolute blast. And there's something about like the addictive replayability of it. Because you play a character, and then you come in and you play a different character. Or you keep playing your character, and there's harder and harder difficulties, and you get better and better gear and better loot. And you go to all these different, like, bazillions of dungeons and strongholds, and, you know, you do all these crazy battles with people. And then with the new expansion that we got not too long ago, the Vessel of Hatred there, they've added whole new late game areas to kind of visit and go to, which are supposed to have even, basically they provide greater levels of replayability, which is truly exciting if you're into that. See, love playing as the Necromancer here, because it's just like, you've got your squad doing all this work and stuff. This is almost too much effort when you're actually, you know, kind of solo battling all these enemies. It's kind of funny. I really get to lay back and let the team go out and do things, which is riveting. But yeah, no, this is a very beautiful game and technically really impressive game. They've done a wondrous job with things. I guess I should also mention, like, cinematics, too, are going to be, like, 30 FPS, I believe, because that's just the way they're done is in a cinematic way, like Blizzard always does, like, very mind-blowing cinematics. So I think, yeah, if it's not, like, in-game and it's, like, a pre-rendered kind of thing, those are going to be the same. Just in case you were wondering on that aspect too. Because that actually has been a thing, is a lot of kind of like frame rate locked. I don't think we... Yeah, it's kind of late to do a dungeon thing. A lot of frame rate locked cinematics and stuff for games running on the Pro are games that have been getting that uncapped or unlocked, which is really neat. Specifically sports games, so much of the crowd stuff would run it, you know, 30 FPS, and it's all been, like, uncapped now for a lot of those titles, which I find quite fascinating. Oh, the Land of the Helltide. Was there anything I was specifically doing there? I mean, I guess I was... you know, I guess I was kind of interacting with stuff. I'm trying to show off different areas if I can, if that makes sense. I'm trying to give you a different feel for different places within the environment. Where was I headed? I was headed somewhere around here. Come on, Necro Bros, you're supposed to protect me while I use my portaling skills. Always thinking of portals. The Altar of Ruin. Like, I'm a giant leopard thing. Oh, I can't wait for future expansions of this game. Like, it was kind of a grindy time, too, and it... I don't know if that one hit as well. Like, my initial review of this game for the Series X was, like, absolutely massive for me. Huge, huge view-getter, which I loved. Obviously, because it was a big success for me. And then, yeah, the expansion wasn't as popular, or near as popular, and I was kind of like, oh, okay. But, you know, it was like a year or something different, so it makes sense. And it's an expansion, so, yeah. Anyways, I digress. The game is fantastic. I love every minute of it. It's, there's a lot going on. It was actually kind of funny how hard it was for me to, like, start a new character when I came back to do... Because basically, when I was doing the review period for Vessel of Hatred, as I said, I had to have, like, a new character because it was a brand new separate build. So it's like starting over without having my abilities, and I did the Spiritborn class. And yeah, the Spiritborn thing. Basically, I had to like restart, and I was like, wow, this is a lot more harder than I remember it being. And then I went through it on stream, and I played through the whole thing like literally a day after having replayed played through the whole expansion. And then I was like, oh, I'm just rolling through this expansion. It was kind of funny, the difference between the two. A little hilarious, but regardless, I'm trying to show you off the different sections, right? Well, we did went to the starter base town that we all love going to. We started off in the jungles of the expansion. We went to the kind of open, creaky, helltide areas, and then here's like a desert escape. So kind of most of the key biomes outside of really diving too far into the snow, but yeah, just trying to give you a vibe for the different sections and how they look. And it really is, it's a lot cleaner, a lot sharper. The visual detail in this was fantastic, so yeah, very, very happy with the visual presentation of this. I think they did a very, very impressive job with it. Yeah, this looks fantastic. What do we have over here? Oh, there's like so much stuff to do in this game too. I'm hoping my map is semi-impressive, but like seriously, there is so much with so many things. Like it takes you hours and hours and hours. And that's not even counting actually like the time that you will spend going in and redoing it and revisiting places and doing things multiple times over or doing new characters and doing seasonal stuff and activities. Like, if you want to be, like, this to be the only game you play, it literally can be, which is terrifying to think of from a gameplay perspective. Yeah, you can literally live off of just playing Diablo 4 here. They genuinely put together something truly special and creative. And, yeah, the fact that it's all multiplayer stuff integrated, too, is really, really quite neat. Because I know some people aren't really fully for that, but I think the results here are genuinely wondrous. And I'm sure this will be, like, the Diablo for, like, well over a decade. This is gonna be, like, the game. All the more impressive, actually. I love visiting all, like, the creepy doomed cellars and dungeons and darkscapes and all that. This game is filled to the brim with activities. It's ridiculous. Still coming across things that you can, like, interact with and visit. It really does feel endless, honestly. It feels like the most endless game you could ever play. I know I did everything, quote-unquote, from exploring places and stuff, but sure, there's still lots of little areas that I haven't really dove into, and yeah, bravo to the team, the Blizzard team, for putting this together. Like, this game is truly a remarkable and expansive experience that looks beautiful here. PlayStation 5 Pro Dance, they absolutely nailed it the whole way through. Oh, look at this creature. What is this doing? Oh, it...